St. Peter's Boys High School. Catholic values. Spirituality. Leadership. Career success. Service to community. Philanthropy. Overcoming challenges. These are the benchmark qualities which St. Peter's has instilled in their students over the first 100 years. And they are the benchmark qualities of our 2019 inaugural class of inductees into the St. Peter's Boys High School Hall of Fame. The Golden Eagle Award honors these incredible men for their exemplified dedication and faithfulness to the mission and ideals of St. Peter's Boys High School, while embodying the essence of the LaSallian spirit. The 2019 inaugural class of inductees to the St. Peter's Boys High School Hall of Fame are Jack Legresi, class of 56.
For over 50 years, Jack Legresi has been one of Staten Island's premier restaurateurs. Proud of his Italian heritage and large family, Jack and his wife Barbara have also been generous donors to many agencies in need around Staten Island. Jack credits his time spent at St. Peter's as essential to setting him on the path towards success.
I think it's extremely important that we support St. Peter's because I think by far it's the best high school on Staten Island, and it gives the most to the children and to the students, and I think it gives them a future.
K. Terrence McGinley, class of 73.
Terrence was born on Staten Island and grew up in New Brighton. He began his career at Harmon Funeral Home in 1973 while he was in college. After his father's death, Terrence became the sole proprietor until selling Harmon Funeral Home in 2011. Terrence is a past member of the St. Peter's Advisory Board and the CYO of Staten Island. He is also a member of the Seton Foundation and numerous other nonprofit organizations. In September 2006, Terrence became a Knight of the Holy Sepulchre of Jerusalem. He is a man of strong Catholic faith who has been married to Arlene Gillen McGinley for over 42 years.
So far, my family has had three generations attending St. Peter's Boys High School, my father, myself, and my two sons. And soon to be, hopefully, my three grandsons will be attending the school also. Great values, great education.
William Murphy, class of 62.
After graduating from St. Peter's, William Murphy went on to Fordham University and then to Harvard School of Law. He became Staten Island's district attorney in 1983 and was the borough's top prosecutor for 21 consecutive years. Survived by his wife Kathy and his two daughters, D.A. William Murphy was an upstanding member of his community and a respected member of the greater New York legal community. While he is greatly missed, as he passed away in 2010, we are honored to induct him into the Hall of Fame and present his wife Kathy with his Golden Eagle Award.
Al Naples, class of 44.
Aloysius Al Naples was a star athlete at St. Peter's Boys High School. He served in the Navy from 1944 to 1946 and then attended Georgetown University, where he continued to be a star athlete for the Hoyas. Years later, he came back to St. Peter's to teach mathematics and to coach basketball and baseball for the Eagles. In addition, he was a department chair and advisor. After 37 years in education, he retired and now lives with his wife Rose in Massachusetts, spending time with their large family.
I've developed a prayer life. I think it all started with the nuns in Blessed Sacrament and continued with the brothers in the high school level. One thing I would make sure you go to confession at least once a month, make sure you attend Mass, and just hope that everything will go according to your plans. Just pursue them the best you can, get as much education as you can, and just live a straight and narrow life.
Thomas D. O'Malley, class of 59.
Tom is a world-renowned businessman, spanning five decades of success in multiple industries. In fact, his reputation precedes him so much that Manhattan College's business school was recently named after him. A man with a sharp sense of humor, a strong moral compass, and an even stronger appreciation for military service. Tom believes that those who gain a lot should give a lot.
I can't speak highly enough about St. Peter's. The education I received prepared me extremely well for the disciplines that I encountered at Manhattan College. And the lessons I learned from the Christian Brothers were very important in my success in life. And certainly the moral teachings were the basis of the very strong family life that I've enjoyed, and the fact that I've been married to Mary Alice for 55 years.
Thomas Quinlan, class of 81.
After graduating St. Peter's, Tom earned an MBA in finance from St. John's University. He became a successful business executive in various billion-dollar communications companies. In 2010, he received an Outstanding Alumni Achievement Medal from St. John's, and in 2011, he was given NYU's prestigious PRISM Award. Tom credits his time at St. Peter's as the launching pad for a life spent in business, but also as an active member of his community and a major philanthropic donor throughout New York City.
The impact that St. Peter's had on me in my life was that it gave me a foundation from which to build upon. It gave me the virtues of life that I use every day in everything that I do.
Establishing the St. Peter's Boys High School Hall of Fame has been an exciting endeavor for our school. We are honored to celebrate these amazing men with you tonight. Please join us in congratulating our inaugural class of Golden Eagles into the St. Peter's Boys High School Hall of Fame.